The current state of Star Wars is so freaking pathetic. I wish that Star Wars was good still, but ever since Disney bought Lucasfilm, it's been a disaster. We have gotten some decent content, like The Clone Wars and also The Mandalorian, but the movies were terrible, the comics were bad, and the novels were also super bad as well, and the people in charge of the franchise couldn't give a single F about it, and now Leslie Headlands decided to do a new interview, and boy oh boy, she genuinely couldn't make herself and also her show The Acolyte look any worse than she already has. She literally admitted one of her writers hadn't seen Star Wars, didn't know Luke and Leia were siblings, and she decided to bash fans for not wanting Star Wars to go political. I'm gonna be reading a thread on Twitter from Data Racer. It says, Leslie Headland interview on her new show. Thinks Star Wars is about politics and fan opinions aren't valid. Hired a writer who's never seen Star Wars. Female and queer representation is a top priority. I literally cry whenever I see it, as you'll see in this thread. She says it multiple times, and it says, this is going to be a train wreck, and I genuinely, honestly could not agree more. Just the way that she sets up this interview, the way that she talks about her focuses on this show, makes it sound like it's going to be a train wreck. Nowhere here does she focus on storytelling, something that actually matters. No. She's worried about all of the wrong things, like super representation, super diversity. She doesn't even have writers who know what Star Wars is about. It does not sound like this show is gonna turn out good. Scrolling over to the next screenshot, it shows off a couple of the titles of different articles and also posts that have been made about this interview. One says, Star Wars The Acolyte showrunner Leslie Headland isn't worried about the passionate fan base of the franchise when it comes to crafting her own show. So one of the headlines refers to her as a super fan, which I think honestly is hilarious, because look at the Kevin Smith situation. He called himself a He-Man super fan, and it turns out that just a couple of years ago he was talking about how he never cared about He-Man. I cannot wait for it to be revealed that she actually isn't a Star Wars super fan. But the playlist said, Leslie Headland explains hiring a writer who hasn't watched Star Wars to help her with her Disney Plus series. Maybe it's just me, maybe I'm the only one with common sense and you all are the only ones with common sense, but why would you hire someone who doesn't understand the franchise that they're writing for? This does not make any sense, in my opinion. So let's go over to the next screenshots that have exact quotes from her, because a lot of these quotes are genuinely ridiculous. So here she talks a lot about female representation and queer representation, and I don't think that a show with a female lead is a bad idea or is instantly woke, but she admitted that the show is female-focused. Behind the scenes, they focused on diversity, and clearly with interviews like this where she admits they had writers who had never watched Star Wars, it's obvious they're more focused on diversity and not good storytelling, which is a shame. In my opinion, as someone who would watch these shows, I just want a good story being told to me. But let's read all of these, because in each one of these screenshots, she says something that digs herself deeper into the hole she already is in with fans. But the first one is, and all that goes for ideology as well. I mean, it's funny because a lot of the feedback that I'll get, and I use that term feedback very lightly, but when I do go on social media, the feedback is, don't make Star Wars political. But I'm like, George Lucas made it political. Those are political films. And then, of course, the person writing this article went on to try to defend her, saying war is, by nature, political. That's just what's up. So yes, that is correct. The name of the franchise is literally Star Wars, but there is a big difference between the politics in Star Wars and the politics we do not want in the franchise. And instead of actually addressing what people don't want, she decided to play dumb. But guys, there's always been politics. The name of the show in the franchise is literally Star Wars. I think that, yes, having a political commentary in a show that has to do with the world it's in is fine, but when you're taking a franchise and putting political themes that have to do with what's going on in the real world right now, isn't what we want in entertainment. We don't want references to current day politics in shows and books and games. If we wanted politics, we'd go and watch the news. We're worried that you're gonna throw BLM messaging into the show, make a few references to holding toxic men accountable for their bad actions, maybe a few LGBT characters so Lucasfilms can get called out less next Pride Month, and a reference to a disgraced leader of the Empire. She knows what we need, but of course she doesn't want to actually address worries, which makes me respect her even less. Going to the next screenshot, though. So there were people like myself out there that were later in life Dave Filoni acolytes. I literally had one writer that was like, I've never seen any of them. I've never seen any Star Wars media. And she's texting me before we start the room, meaning she had already been hired, saying Luke and Leia are brother and sister. Why would you admit you had writers who knew nothing about Star Wars? I mean, holy shit, why would you do that? It literally gives people zero confidence in your ability to make this show good. Clearly, she's not worried about storytelling or the show being good. She's just worried about cramming as much representation into it as possible, which is so disappointing for me. I am fine with representation and inclusivity as long as you are telling a good story. And she here doesn't talk about having a good story. She's talking about all of the wrong things like ideology, politics, representation, nothing here that has to do with the story of the show. Continuing on, though, it says to have the power when you're creating media to just put in certain types of people that maybe aren't necessarily in normal mainstream content or media is just. I know that for people who don't identify that way, it doesn't seem that important, but to us, it's huge. I literally saw a commercial with two women going on vacation, and I was like, again, crying. It just hits you on another level that you don't know you're missing until you see it. And continuing on, she talks about two other times crying. You have to feel like this is speaking directly to you, regardless of what you might be going through. At what point in your life you're going through it? That being said, as somebody that is a lesbian, every time I see gay or queer representation in media, I scream with happiness. And again, she points out that she is a lesbian. Again, I think that it's perfectly fine if she wants to have a strong female lead and she wants to have a little representation in there. But the problem we have is when all you do is shove it in our face. Nowhere in this interview does she actually talk about the story she wants to tell, her vision, her direction. All she talks about is crying over representation because she's so proud of the way that the industry's going, bashing fans for not wanting Star Wars to go real world politics, and she literally admits that she has writers who have never seen Star Wars. She can create what she wants, but she cannot cry and complain when Star Wars fans don't want to watch this because that's what's going to happen. Yeah, I'm sure that there's going to be viewers no matter what because it's Star Wars, but I'll bet the initial audience is going to be much weaker than The Mandalorian if this is the type of PR they plan to put out, if these are the type of statements they want to run on. But let everyone know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to give it a like, share it, and subscribe to the channel. And of course, if you didn't, make sure to give it a dislike. I appreciate your support either way. But I will talk to you all again in the next video really soon.